This is a cone beam CT scan. This is taking the place slowly but surely of regular x-rays. Now the first thing I look at is this three-dimensional view. This gives me a good idea, a good overview of what I'm looking at, what to look for. I do my actual analysis on the 3D view, or the 2D views that you see on the right side of the screen. But this gives me some good overall information. I can look at the discs or the disc spaces. I can look at the holes between the bones where nerves come out. I can look straight down from the brain down through the spinal cord, through the cervical spine, just to see what's going on there. So that's always what I start with first, just to get an overall view of what's going on. Then I move to the 2D views, and the first thing I do is I create these red lines that kind of square up the skull so that I have some reference points. On this picture here, their head is pretty level, but on this picture here, you can see there's quite a bit of tilt towards the right. We want to look at the top joint in the spine where the skull sits on the top bone in the neck. We're looking at the joints here on each side, and we'll take some measurements of it. I'm just going to do a really quick version. We spend a bit more time. There's a bit more of a process to it when we're really analyzing something, but you can see it's about the same on both sides for this particular patient. And then we're going to look at each side particularly. So I want to look right down the outside edge of that joint there. We're going to see that over here. And we need to change the angle a little bit so we can see right down the joint. All right, now it clears up. Looks pretty even there. The outside edge of the atlas and the outside edge of the occipital condyle, or the bottom of the skull. So let's take a look at the other side. Overall, this process takes about an hour. Now, if you look here, you can actually see a very small misalignment there. This particular patient, the atlas, or the bone underneath the skull, has moved a little bit to the left and forward of the actual skull itself and gotten stuck. So we're going to need to design an adjustment to slide the bone right back down there. And one of the tools to help us do that, and again, I would be a little more careful when I'm actually analyzing it, but we're going to look at what the angle is there, so we know how to place our body in comparison to the patient to slide the bone back into place without twisting and popping. Now, there's a lot of other things that we analyze.